Greets, peeps! It's the Living Fruits on YouTube. So, I've learned a new word recently. A few new words, actually. One of them is satsang, the other one is dashan. The one I'm going to talk about today is sadhana. Dashan means to sit quietly at the feet of your master, your guru, after you've had that long conversation, and you know, just allows you to allow that great information, if it was great for you, to kind of like sink in, and it's like a form of respect as well. But right now I'm going to talk about sadhana, which is a Sanskrit word, and in simple terms it means a spiritual practice or a ritual, daily ritual of some description. I came across that word because I was listening to Muji's teachings and he kept on saying this word, and also when I was in India. And I'm like, what is this word? So obviously you know, remember that Google is your friend. And I was like, oh, wicked, excellent, I love that. Spiritual rituals are not something that's new to me. I've been doing them for years. But it's really good to have a new context and a new way of understanding them. Since coming back from India, I have been practicing a form of sadhana, which involves being peaceful, taking that time, whether it's 10 minutes, 20 minutes, to just be with self in a quiet space. I might also listen to a guided meditation. At the moment, that again is Sri Muji. I might do yoga or just listen to some nice spiritual music. Journaling, of course, how could I forget that? Journaling. And it might be just the thoughts that have come up, inspirational thoughts or things I think will be interesting to read back over or share. Or it could be complaining, or it could be like morning pages, or it could be, I might feel to write down the daily gratitude ritual that I like to do. That's kind of what I include in my sadhana, let's call it my sadhana. I love to do it daily, and when I drop off and I don't do it, it just all builds up. And that energy needs to find somewhere to go. If you face yourself daily, it's really an empowering thing. It's an empowering thing to face yourself daily. So real quick, I want to talk about gratitude and including that as a practice in your daily life. So there are two expressions that I use. One is to give thanks for what you are grateful for now. You might affirm something like, I am so very grateful for the people that tune into my YouTube channel. I am so very grateful that the sun is out today because it makes me feel so happy. I am so very grateful for the home that I live in. I am so very grateful for my family. I'm so happy that I have a son. I'm so happy that I have children. The things you are grateful for now, and it can be the big things and the small things. I am so very grateful for being able to take one breath in and one breath out. On those days where it's really hard to find something to be grateful for, just go general. Just go with the things that you take for granted. You know, I'm so very grateful that I have a mind that can think and create. Sometimes you have to really go general. The thing about being grateful and expressing that gratitude to the universe, whether you say it out loud or whether you say it in your head or whether you write it down, is that then the universe knows that you're communicating and it knows what to provide for you. It's a two-way conversation. And the other expression of gratitude that I work with are grateful intentions. So to be grateful for the things that you intend to happen in your life. So you could kind of look at that as goals as well. You know, like if you're going for a job interview, you've been for a job interview, you could affirm, I am so very grateful for the excellent decision that I'll get about my job interview, but you could also like make it a bit shorter. I am so very grateful for the money that I will get from that contract. I am so very grateful that my son did well in his exams. You can affirm the things that haven't already happened yet, but that you intend to happen. You can intend to be healthy. I am so very grateful for the juicing that I am doing next week. You know, like that. So they're the two expressions of gratitude. And then when all else fails, I got this one recently and from Muji, just say thank you. Just say thank you. You know when you have that feeling of gratitude in you or you don't, just say thank you. You could be getting onto the subway or the tube and the fact that you have this flipping ability to move around, just say thank you. You don't have to say out loud, but just be like thank you, just thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. You know, you're eating your food, thank you, thank you, thank you. It's a communication, it's an expression, and it makes you feel good. You know, I once was kind of invited to do a motivational talk in an orphanage in Africa, and there were little kids and there were also, you know, older kids, and there was also the staff. And my friend who was there, she hosted us to this venue, And Sheila said, and you know, now Esther is going to do a motivational talk. I could have throttled her, but you know when you're called into being? And I spoke about gratitude. These people, they hardly had anything, but the fact that they had what they had was better than, you know, what their fate could have been. And even if you're on the street, there's still something to be grateful for, that you are alive, that, you know, someone gave you money. There's always something to be grateful for. Anyway, I did this talk about gratitude, and it was just really heartful. Heartful is that a word? It just gave them, you know, just gave the children and young people and the staff something. It's a little one, but it's huge as well. I also wanted to share a little catch up on like where I am in my awakening. Oh, I swear, the things that happen. But I'm going to talk about crying. Like, I'm always crying. But it's teaching me about the quality of what it is to shed tears. Because we think of crying as it's always got to be some sad situation. And I remember reading about this in Iyanla's book, Yesterday I Cried. And she would talk about the different flavour. She would say, like, some tears are salty, some are sweet, some are warm. Years later, I'm kind of experiencing my understanding of that. I just think that I'm more sensitive, more open. And there's also, you know, about learning how to protect yourself from different kinds of energies. But the tears and the different qualities of tears, I think that it's spirit communicating. And the last time I cried was, you know, during sadhana one morning, and I sat down, and you know, these days I sit down immediately. That's my cat. It's starting to rain. The cats start to lose their minds a little bit when it rains, when the weather's changeable, isn't it? I remember my mum would say that when the cats were like running about, she's like, oh, it's gonna rain. Anyway, recently, this is a couple of days ago in sadhana, like I just sat down, and as soon as I sit down, I'm like, I'm just in the space, you know, just that peace. And that I know is because of my awakening breakthrough that happened at the satsang, which you'll see in my video about Muji and going to satsang. Anyway, I'll put a link. And I just felt this gratitude, and I started to give thanks, and I just started crying. You know, tears just started to come. I was so grateful. Like, even for the tree that I could see out the window, I was just so grateful, and this really moved me. I also get moved and tears come when I witness someone or see someone who's coming from their heart. And it doesn't even matter if it's like in a play or on a TV program, it just makes me want to cry. So things in the news, like watching the news the other day, which I don't do very often because it is just too much for me sometimes. It was about the war in Syria, and there was this woman talking about something that had happened, or she was just, you know, being sort of beseeching something that had happened, but she was talking from the heart. That just, it just, you know, it just had me. I was just in tears. But even like on TV, an episode of EastEnders where a father and son were talking about their love, and even though it was being acted, it made me cry, because it was this, you know, father-son, and you know, they're talking about their connection. Because it was coming from heart, it moved me. I just cry often these days. But it's not always sad tears. Like, 9 times out of 10, it's not sad tears. And I have this kind of, this peace that just is there all the time. And even if I feel sad, I just have this sense of this peace and this stillness inside of me. So I know that it's just the mind, it's just the person who's, you know, having the emotional feelings, but my consciousness is at peace, like always, and I just feel so connected with that. So yeah, this crying. I remember my very, very first awakening. This was like years ago, my son was small, so it was a long time ago. And if you want to hear about that awakening, just let me know in the comments and I'll include it in another video. But yeah, the crying. Who knew there was so many qualities in the shedding of tears? I had no idea. Oh, and I just really wanted to share about what happened in yoga last night. Oh my word. So we were doing this stretch, this pose at the end, where like the knee was pulled in, and you know, you felt the stretch in the glutes, the arm goes over the knee. And on the left side, I could do the stretch. On the right, my body just refused. It was just like, no. And it really hurt. Like at the top of my thigh, like near my groin, was just like hurting. And I was just all stiff. And then Fatu, my yogi, she was like, oh. She was like, where is it hurting? She's like, because I think she kind of knows when a certain part of your body is speaking. And she did have a little bit of a smile on her face. And she said, or after I said what I said, she said that the right hand side is masculine. And I was like, ah, that makes sense. You know, like why there was a refusal for that side of me to cooperate. I mean, I can't think of anything specific that I was thinking about, you know, relationships or men in my life, but there must have been something going on underneath the surface because it was just a refusal to move. And as soon as she said it's the male side, it was like, oh yeah, that makes sense. So obviously some resistance there. And I did yoga this morning and wow, it's gonna be a storm. Did you hear that? And it's probably got a bit darker as well. I did it again. I practiced the pose this morning during my yoga practice, and it was a bit more flexible on the right hand side. So, you know, the stiffness and then talking about it has obviously released something. I don't want to be holding anything, you know. I want to invite love into my life. I am inviting love into my life and, you know, to experience that which will fulfill me in the form of relationship. Look, I'm going all shy talking about that now. Okay, so there's a perfect place for me to end this video. Question. When was the last time that you cried? Do speak about it in the comments. If it's like traumatic and it's deep and it's a lot, write me at livingfruits@gmail.com. But if it's something that's shareable, share in the comments and let's just have a conversation. Or comment on this video about gratitude or whatever you would like. And I will see you next time. So thank you for watching. Please give this video a thumbs up, share, subscribe if you're new here, and welcome to the Fruit Fam. And don't forget to keep reaching for those fulfilling thoughts.